Okay, hello everyone. Today we're going to be talking about oxidoreductases. Some of you may have noticed that the word oxidoreductases may seem familiar. This is because it contains an ox and a red. If you combine these others and switch them around, they equal the redox, which you already know from the redox reaction. I made a video on that. Go check that out. Redox reaction stands for reduction and oxidation. Reduction being a gain in electrons, and an oxidation being a loss of electrons. There are many kinds of oxidoreductases. For example, if you look them up on Wikipedia, it will show you 21. I'm not going to show you all of them, because some of them are so minor that there would be no point. I'm going to show you some of them, and if you're interested, and want to see some in particular on this channel, then write them down in the comments. For now, we have the oxidase. This catalyzes the transfer of electrons. We have a reduced substance, which wants to turn into an oxidated substance, which the oxidase turns into an oxidated substance with H2O, because it uses H and O, hydrogen and oxygen, to oxidate the substance. Next up, we have the oxygenase. These catalyze the incorporation of oxygen into a substrate. That means that now we have a reduced substrate here, which in combination with some oxygen turns into oxidized substrate, with one of the components being oxygen, and of course the side product of water. Next up, we have the peroxidase. Peroxidases usually break up peroxides. For this example, we have H2O2, which is hydrogen peroxide. In combination with two electrons and two positively charged hydrogen atoms, these turn into two H2O. This is because H2O2 may be harmful to the human body. There's actually a disease which causes the enzyme of catalase, which induces this kind of reaction, to malfunction or to not be present at all. These damage the mucous membrane and similar. So the catalase takes the H2O2 and turns it into water, which is obviously less harmful and even good for the body. Last but not least for this list, we have the hydrogenase. The hydrogenase induces a reversible oxidation or reduction of hydrogen. For example, we have the molecule of H2 with an oxidized acceptor. That means that it lacks a few electrons and wants to have more. Hence, it takes them away from the H2, effectively turning it into 2H+. Now it is reduced because it just gained electrons, but it's still an acceptor for this reaction because it accepted these electrons. Then we have the reduced donor. That means it has spare electrons that it wants to give away. He sees the 2H+ and sees its positive charge. That means that here some electrons lack. And it gives it to them. So now the H2 molecule is neutrally charged, has no charge, and the donor becomes oxidized. That means it lost electrons. These kind of enzymes, the oxidoreductases, are important when it comes to building electron transport chains. These are especially important in the mitochondria, in the process of producing ATP. But that's another story. Stay smart. And that's it for the video. If you like the channel and want to see more every Saturday, then feel free to subscribe. You can always change your mind, and it's totally free.